Progressive Democratic Students Association, Housing Student Friend and Telangana Vidyarthi Vedika. Welcome you to this evening. Now I am here to give the welcome note why we are here. What is the actual background of this evening? All the popular festivals in India have become the tools to carry out the hegemonic caste Hindu politics, through which the Varna system is continued to survive. After 15, it can be observed that many anti-Brahmin historical events, incidents and occasions have been appropriated and legitimized as Hindu festivals and fired back on the descendants of the people heroes who have made the history by fighting against the Brahminical hegemony. A great Dalit revolutionary poet, Shivasagar, reflects in vain very recently in a small piece of poem, Nadustunna Charitra, says the following line. Shambhupudu pedala meeda chirunavuto ramunni vadistunnadu. Shambhupudu pedala meeda chirunavuto ramunni vadistunnadu. Ekalavyudu droni patala velanu koddalito nadustunnadu. ఏకలవ్యుడు ద్రోణుని పొటల వేలును గొడ్డలితో నరుకుతున్నాడు. బలి తన చిరు పాదాలతో వామనుని పాతాలాన్ని తొక్కేస్తున్నాడు. ఓహో, ఇప్పుడు నడుస్తున్న చరిత్ర పరమచండాలకు చరిత్ర. ఇన్ అదర్ వర్డ్స్, వాట్ హీ సేస్ ఇస్ ద టైమ్ హ్యాస్ కమ్ టు రికగ్నైజ్ ద నెసెసిటీ టు రివర్స్ ద హిస్టరీ, to know the facts underlying in the contemporary popular cultures. Yes, we, the organizers, also believe it is the time to reverse the history. In the lines left by the social revolutionaries, Mahatma Jyotirao Phule, Dr. B.R. Ambedkar, Ayyangari, Shivasagar, it is we who have to shoulder the responsibility of reversing the history. It is in this light of knowledge the organizations for organizing the TSA, DAMSA, PSU, BSF and TVB have started looking into the history to create a debate around the events which are the dark days in the lives of the Dalits and Bahujans across the country, which have been observed as celebrations for the upper caste Hindus. The festivals such as Dasara, Diwali and tomorrow's Onam are all to be understood as the black days of the Dalits and Bahujans, but they are all celebrated on the murders of the Dalit Bahujan kings. Like other festivals, Onam too has different dimensions accorded to it. Be it a celebration of Aval or be it a celebration of the return of the great king Bali, it needs to be remembered here that Onam, as the popular myth goes, is celebrated welcoming the return of resurrection of Bali for one day. This was a boon given to the Bali, a just king, by his murderer Vaman, who represents Brahmanic hegemon. If Onam is celebrated to welcome the king Bali, one needs to question ourselves that how we are looking the murderer Vaman and the society he represents. As far as my knowledge goes, nowhere in the celebrations of Onam, Vamana even accused of the murder of their king. Instead, he and his society that he represents are held high and celebrated. Not only in this context, but also in all the popular cultural, popular caste Hindu festivals, village, or let's say the murderers have been held high and legitimized as heroes, while the just kings who were murdered have been portrayed as symbols of evils and demons. It is quite contradicting that the killing of just our own king is celebrated, instead mourned and declared it as the saddest days of our lives. In the recent past, especially in the 80s and 90s, the Dalits and Bahujan, especially Dalits of the Kerala, who have been protesting the celebrations of war for the still continuation of the discrimination of the Dalits, have been raising severe protests, be it in front of raising rallies or hunger strike. So this gives us a clear picture of how this popular festival have been discriminated. This is actually the background response, the stage for this, today's evening. And now I request guests of today, guests and speakers of today, Mr. Vaidya Chakravarti, research scholar, EFLU University Department of Cultural Studies. Now I welcome him onto the stage. Second, Mr. Sunny M. Kapikar, Dalit activist and critique from Kerala. Now I request him to come on to the stage. Now I request Mr. Raju Nayak, assistant professor of EFL University, to come on to the stage. Chief guest of today and chief speaker, Professor Kancha Alaya, who have written so many books. First, we have created tremors with his first book, Why I Am Not a Hindu, and still debating the recent book, Post Hindu India. Now I request Professor Kancha Alaya to come on to the stage. And now I hand over the mic to Mr. Raju Nayak to preside over the entire evening.